Yummy poison. I mean, star poison. I mean, something that once caused the death of a star. Never mind. You'll understand in a second with my extracting star poison from cereal experiment. Hi, everyone. I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we learn about all things space and science. So grab your magnets and prepare to never look at cereal the same way again. Emily's Science Lab. Stay curious. Today, we are extracting iron, otherwise known as star poison, from cereal. Why is it known as star poison? Well, it's because stars are these big, bright, beautiful engines that fuse lighter elements into heavier ones. And big stars, they will fuse hydrogen into helium, which is then fused into carbon, which is then fused into oxygen, and then silicon, and then eventually, silicon is fused to create iron. And boy, oh boy, here's the bad news. It costs more energy to produce iron than it creates. And so by producing iron, a star will eventually die. By exploding into a supernova, collapsing into a neutron star, or becoming a black hole. But either way, iron was the start of its downfall. And we will be extracting it from cereal today. For this one, what you need is 2 cups of cereal with reduced iron in the ingredients. I use Honey Bunches of Oats, which had the 90% recommended value of iron in it, and then 1 to 1.5 cups of water. This will depend on the type of cereal that you are using, a Ziploc bag, and a strong magnet. So the first thing we wanna do is put 2 cups of cereal in your Ziploc bag. This is 1.5 cups. I'm gonna start with 1.25. All right, let's see how that looks. We wanna mush it up a little bit, just like that. And you can always add more later if it doesn't look like the right consistency. But so far, this looks pretty good. Now what we're going to do is we're going to wait for your cereal to get a little bit more mushy, and that's gonna take between 30 minutes to an hour. So just set this aside for about 30 minutes and come back and check it. Parents and adults, this is a great one for littles to do because they can do the squishing and they can really play with the cereal, but make sure that you are very careful with your magnets, especially with small fingers and little kids. After 30 to 60 minutes, your cereal will look like this. Cereal mush. But we want our cereal to be a little bit more liquidy than this because what we're gonna do is use our magnet to extract these teeny tiny iron particles out of the cereal, and we want them to more easily flow through our cereal mush. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the last 1/4 cup of water in here, just like that. Reseal your bag and mush it up again. Just get that to be all mixed through. Now, for the fun part. So I'm gonna get all the air out of my bag so I can really get in contact with my cereal. And you wanna take your strong magnets and we are just going to massage the cereal. And the easiest way I have found to do this is to massage it toward a corner of the bag. So we are going to direct as much iron as possible to one of the corners of the bag. So I'm just gonna start doing this, moving the magnet across the cereal and directing everything I can to the corner of the bag. You just wanna do this for about 30 seconds or so. And iron is attracted to a magnet because iron is something known as ferromagnetic, which means it's attracted to a magnet. And that is the way that we can extract our iron out of the cereal. Oh, I think I'm starting to see some.
This is so cool.
Okay, so now it's really coming out of the cereal. Do you see that? Look at those iron filings. It's so wild to me that we have metal in our cereals, but here's the thing. That's intentional. That's a good thing, in fact, because iron creates hemoglobin, which is a protein that helps move oxygen throughout our blood, which is why they put it in cereal.
Whoa, look at them go. That's awesome. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Thank you for extracting star poison from cereal with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring books for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.